first assignment is the most important thing. It's your handshake to an editor. You know, you'll never forget that first assignment, and it will make or break whatever your future relationship is with that client.
Do your research, make it something interesting, and know what we produce, you know? So, like, don't send me, like, an architecture portfolio.
Be able to say, like, what you can do for that editor, and do it in a unique, personalized way. Copy and paste will kill you every time, every time.
Personalized, either with a pitch or maybe like where you're traveling to, if you already have a story in mind, where you're going. Those are really helpful things to include in an email.
Don't just email someone and say, hey, and then a link to your portfolio, which is a thing that like super happens pretty regularly.
I'm always considering who the photographer is on top of what their work is.
Lack of people skills is a big thing. And also arrogance. Like, it shouldn't have to be said.
There are a ton of good photographers, but they're not always great people, and that's the easiest way to separate yourself. There are plenty of people that can make the images for our stories. It's really about who that person is, how they carry themselves, and what their interactions are like.
So we have a monthly budget. We don't have a lot of wiggle room. I think that we're very clear on like what our day rate is and what our pickup rate is. We try to offer the best. Like, we're not gonna cheat you out on anything.
You had brought up the New York Times rate of being $200, and we actually just raised it to $450. It was a pretty publicized rate hike, which was very exciting. So we're paying $450 for a traditional assignment fee and $300 for what's considered like a half day sort of quick hit assignment.
We tend to have a set rate for different projects, so it varies depending on what we're working on, but we're always like open. Like, my biggest thing for photographers is to talk to me. Like, I appreciate transparency, and I hope that you are the same way with me.
I haven't found any new photographers through Instagram, but I will say that when I'm looking at a photographer's portfolio site, or if someone is coming in for a meeting, I'll always look at their Instagram account. A photographer's portfolio can sometimes be a curated look at what they think that I want to see. And a lot of times an Instagram feed can be a little bit more unfiltered and a little bit more personal. There have been occasions where I've said like, oh, like this series of pictures on your Instagram was actually like kind of cool. Would you think about applying that kind of approach to this?